Hello everyone, my today's video lecture will talk about combustion chamber. So the objective of my today's video lecture is to provide you the brief introduction and the basic idea about the combustion chamber and how it works, then the type of combustion chamber involved and how they differ from each other. So what is combustion chamber actually? See, it is a section where pressurized air from the compressor enters and fuel is mixed, then allowed to burn with the help of igniters, then that combustion product is allowed to discharge over the turbine section in order to provide the RPM such that the turbine will start rotating at higher RPM and hence the turbine will rotate the compressor. So the combustion chamber converts your chemical energy of fuel into thermal energy, which is later converted into work by the turbine. So the combustion chamber are made up of super alloys. Super alloys means they are the high strength alloy. Examples you can see inconel or nickel base alloy, those are known as super alloys because high temperature exists in combustion chamber. That's why we prefer super alloy. And combustion chamber is also known as burner. In combustion chamber, the burning of gases will take place at constant pressure, but the temperature of the gases will rise continuously. So in this diagram you can see here 2300 Kelvin is in primary zone, then intermediate zone is 1800 Kelvin, then in dilution zone it is 1300 Kelvin. So the combustion process is divided into three zones, that is primary, secondary and the dilution zone. In primary zone, your air, that is pressurized air, will get mixed with the fuel and burning of these gases will take place. After that, the cool air will enter from these holes provided on the liner so that efficient combustion can be achieved or complete combustion can take place in the intermediate zone, and at last in dilution zone additional amount of cooled air is added so that the temperature of the gases will get dropped, and in order to provide the safer and durable operation of a turbine. See, if the temperature of the gases will be higher, then there may be a chances that turbine blade will get rupture or will get melt. So we have to use a higher strength material so that turbine blade should not get rupture. So because of that, what we did, we are reducing the temperature of that combustion product so that the whatever material we are preferring in the turbine blades, of course we are using super alloys over there also, but then also there will be a melting point for that material also. That's why we are reducing the temperature of the combustion product in the dilution zone so that the safer and durable operation of a turbine blade can be achieved. So these are the three zones present in the combustion chamber. Now the combustion process, you can read these points. The combustion process is divided into three zones, that is primary, secondary and dilution zone. Mixing of air, fuel and its burning take place in primary zone. Then cool air is added in intermediate zone through holes to support combustion so that complete combustion can be achieved. High amount of cool air is added in dilution zone in order to reduce the temperature of hot gases. So now, what are the types of combustion chamber? Combustion chambers are of two types, that is through type combustion chamber and reverse flow type combustion chamber. Now in through type combustion chamber, we have three types, that is can type, can annular type and annular type. In all these three combustion chamber, annular type combustion chamber are preferred in commercial aircraft, We are not using can type and can annular type. The reason is annular type is a small bucket type chamber, means we have only a single chamber or section where combustion take place. But in can type, multiple cans are arranged around a central shaft. So you can see this diagram, that is can type combustion chamber, where you can find multiple cans are arranged. You can see number of cans are there. So these cans, since these cans will provide you combustion, and this hollow section is for shaft, means your compressor section is here, so compressor shaft will go, and here turbine, your turbine section will be, turbine blade will be attached. So turbine and compressor, in between you will find this combustion chamber section. So the air will enter through these section and fuel will mixed through the fuel nozzle, and then igniter will provide you the ignition part. So in can type combustion chamber, multiple cans are arranged around a central shaft. So each can will have its own igniter and fuel nozzle. So the maintenance part will be easier in this type of combustion chamber, because whenever inspection is required, you can replace a single can and maintenance can be provided. But the difficult part for this type of combustion chamber is that if the igniter get failed, the wastage of fuel cannot be minimized, means your fuel will continuously supplied and it cannot be stopped to prevent wastage. So multiple cans are arranged around a central shaft with each having a separate igniter and fuel nozzle. Maintenance is easier and wastage of fuel cannot be minimized if any igniter fails. This one is a disadvantage of this type of combustion chamber, and maintenance is easier is an advantage of can type combustion chamber. Such type of combustion chamber are preferred with centrifugal flow compressor. The aircraft which is having centrifugal flow compressor, that prefer can type combustion chamber. Now for annular combustion chamber. So in annular combustion chamber, as I said, these type of combustion chamber are preferred with commercial aircraft which uses axial flow compressor. So nowadays all commercial aircraft prefer axial flow compressor. So in axial flow compressor, we have flow, that is air flow, in axial, that means parallel to the axis of rotation, and the pressurized air will enter from this section and exit from this section, that means here turbine blade will be placed. So we have only single chamber where igniter will be there and fuel nozzle. So each engine will have two igniters, correct? So in on aircraft we have two engine, so we have four igniters total. On each engine we have two igniters. So in this type of combustion chamber we are using only two igniters, whereas in can type combustion chamber we are using separate igniter for every combustion chamber. Now in annular type combustion chamber, maintenance will be difficult. Why? Because in order to provide inspection or maintenance, you have to replace the whole combustor, and it is efficient comparative to other type of combustor. So this will be the advantage and this will be the disadvantage for this type of combustion chamber. Now last type, can annular type. It is a combination of both, that is annular and can type, means you have a multiple cans and around which in one annular case. So in this type of combustion chamber, you will achieve efficient operation, but they are heavier than other types. So we are not using such type of combustion chamber in commercial airlines. You have annular case in which multiple cans are arranged. Here again you are using only two igniters and flame propagation tube is preferred in such type of combustion chamber, such that once you provide ignition, the flame propagation tube will provide ignition in other cans also. So this is why this is good, because it is using the combination effect of both kind of combustion chamber. So combination of both type of combustion chamber, combination effect it is using for the both type, like can and annular type combustion chamber. Now summary. So combustion chamber is one where combustion process take place. Combustion process carried out in three zones, that is primary, intermediate and dilution zone. Combustion chamber are of two types, that is through type and reverse flow type. In reverse flow, see, reverse flow I have not discussed because we are not using reverse flow type combustion chamber in commercial airlines. So in reverse flow, actually 180 degrees pay you are reversing the flow, and you have a deflector in that reverse flow annular combustion chamber, reverse flow chamber. So I don't have that much point, but I will discuss in some other video about those types. Now through type combustion chamber are of three type, that is can type, annular type and can annular type. So this much for this combustion chamber. Thank you.